I've only got 20 people following me and I'm putting stuff out and nothing happens. And it feels really demotivating, really frustrating. And it can lead to this sense of failure, sense of what's the point, sense of I'm never going to be able to figure this out, I'm never going to be able to make this happen. And it's entirely the wrong mindset to be in. I also feel like so much time is wasted on social media for very, very, very little return. I really feel like there's a bigger way or a faster way, a more impactful way we can create momentum and create visibility that does not include social media. Hello, I am so happy that you're here and I'm excited to have this conversation with you because I actually want to dive into something today that has been coming up a lot lately. And it's how to create more visibility and have more of an impact and build more momentum without social media. I'm excited for this one. But anyway, yeah, I'm sat in my office today. Yesterday was actually International Women's Day. And we opened the doors to FEA HQ for the first time ever. And we hosted a little coffee and cake morning for loads of amazing women. It was incredible. We had 40 tickets available and managed to sell 55. I don't even know how that happened. I think James kept sneaking people in. but it was so amazing to have the office filled with incredible women and the conversations and the energy. It was just so nice after everything, you know, with COVID for the past few years and not being able to do this stuff. It was just really nice to get together with women and just also just kind of talk about the ways that we want to impact the world and the things we want to do. And I think it's so important right now, especially with everything going on in the world. And it sometimes feels really hard to keep going. I think sometimes it feels hard because there's so much heaviness right now and it can feel overwhelming and it can feel like what we're doing is so insignificant and that we shouldn't keep putting our stuff out there and because there's more important things going on. And I completely get that 100%. But I also feel like we can make more of a difference and have more of an impact if we keep putting our message out there. And also the more successful, the more wealth we can build for ourselves, the more, like undoubtedly, the more power it gives us, because with that wealth, we can make such a difference. We can have a bigger say because that is just how this world works, unfortunately. But we can have a bigger say. We can do so much more. We can help. We can give more. When we've got a bigger platform to stand on, we can make a bigger difference. So I just think that it's so important for us, especially as women, because I feel like we're just amazing. but like the women I come across, you know, building businesses, I feel like we, not taking anything away from men, but I just feel like so many of the conversations I have do center around us wanting to make a difference, to have an impact, to, you know, we bring a real, really powerful feminine energy that I just think the world blooming needs right now. And I think we really need to lean into that and to keep going. And I think that's why being surrounded by other women and keeping each other positive and keeping each other upright and being a shoulder for each other, it's just so, so important right now as we kind of navigate through these very unsettling times. So it was really nice to get everyone together and to have really great conversations. That we had lots of cakes left over afterwards. And I realized that I suppose having cupcakes at an event is just not a good idea because I picked one up and then I was like, how am I supposed to eat this cupcake? Well, I'm trying to have a conversation. I just can't just shove it in my mouth. It's going to go all over my nose. It's going to be everywhere. So I think next time we'll do little nibbles, lesson learned. So something that's been coming up a lot lately, and it's because I'm running the Create and Sell program at the moment, and so I've been seeing this coming up a lot in terms of people asking how can they create visibility, and so many of us are so focused on like growing through social media. And don't get me wrong, I've loved using social media. It's been a really great way for me to create visibility and to get my business out there, get myself out there. That being said, I also feel like so much time is wasted on social media for very, very, very little return. And I really feel like there's a bigger way or a faster way, a more impactful way we can create momentum and create visibility that does not include social media. And I want to share this with you because this is how I started my business. And if I was starting a business again today from scratch, these are the exact things that I would do to help me get it off the ground, build momentum and create visibility. So instead of focusing on, you know, trying to build a social media presence and being like, oh my gosh, but I've only got 20 people following me and nothing's happening and putting stuff out and nothing happens. And it feels really demotivating, really frustrating. And it can lead to this feeling of like a sense of failure, sense of what's the point, sense of I'm never going to be able to figure this out. I'm never going to be able to make this happen. And it's entirely the wrong mindset to be in. So instead of doing that, or alongside doing that, if you want, I think a more important thing is to figure out what do you want to be known for and how are you going to get known for that thing locally? When I started FEA, I was like, right, I've got this idea. I want to create this platform to bring together women all over the world. I have no idea how I'm going to do this, but I need to get out there and start talking to people. So I went on good old Google and I started looking up different things that were going on in my area. And obviously now as we're coming out of everything with COVID, event, I know it's different for people in different countries, but there are definitely more and more things happening and that will happen over the next few months and so on. That we can get involved in. So back when I started FEA, I looked at what was going on around me and I looked at the events I could go to. Now I am pretty introverted. And so plucking up the courage and the energy to go along to these events was a lot, but I just knew I had to do it. If I wanted to make this work, if I wanted to get this vision out there, I had to do it. So I found different events to go to and some were blooming awful and some were really great. And the great ones I kept going to and the people I met at the great ones told me other events they went to. And I started going to those other events. And before I knew it, I was going to really local events. I was going to events in the city center and I was meeting all these different people. And when I was going, I was just going with the view to connect with people. It wasn't nothing. I didn't have anything to sell because this is the other thing that I hear so many people say is like, surely I need something to sell before I start putting myself out there. And no, no, no. You need to get yourself out there now from day one, before day one, when you've got this vision, this mission, you want to do something, you want to create something, you need to get out there now and start casting the vision and start getting people on board with your mission. That is the most important thing. And so for me, I was going to these events to build meaningful relationships and just also to say, like, someone asked me like, oh, what are you doing? Oh, I started a business in 2005 and I just found it so lonely and so I felt so isolated. And so I really want to build a platform to help inspire and empower women to build successful businesses. So I want to bring us together. I want to do interview series. I want to find a way to just really support women and help them to create success and for us to come together. So as I was casting this vision and talking to people about it, they were like, oh, wow, that sounds amazing. And talking about like, obviously, I was there to listen to other people and I was also there with my mindset of how can I just support other people? What could I do that would really support and validate and help other people to be seen and heard? Because everyone just wants to feel seen and heard and validated. So how could I show up and do that for the people? And so that's all I did. And in doing that, I started to build relationships and people started to become interested in me. And so that gave me an opportunity to cast my vision of what it was that I was trying to create. And when I did it from the perspective of not here's what I have to offer and sell, but this is my mission. And when I casted the vision for the mission, it enabled people to like get on board my mission with me. So people who believed in what I believed in, people who were like, yeah, that's going to be incredible. They then came on board, you know, like obviously not really, really on board, but they just kind of stood next to me to help me. So they would be like, oh my gosh, you need to meet this person. Oh my gosh, you need to go along to that event. Oh my gosh, have you heard about this? You should get involved in that. And then all of a sudden these opportunities opened up. And before I knew it, I was going to loads of different events. I knew all sorts of people and I had wheedled my way into the local and somewhat extended networking scene. So my local is in my town and then the city scene as well. And I also looked at organizations that I might be able to have an impact with or I might be able to get involved with. So for me, obviously looking at helping with like women in business, I connected with organizations like the Institute of Directors, got involved with them. I started going along, and you know, when you show up to be helpful, just to be helpful and not ask for anything in return, it's amazing what doors will open and what relationships will build. So I got involved in the Institute of Directors and I was just there to be helpful. But it made me feel like I was building momentum. People were listening to me. They were listening to what I was doing. It gave me opportunities to like meet other incredible people. And I'm pretty sure, I think I got an opportunity to speak even. I can't remember now. So I got in touch with like organizations like that. I also got in touch with organizations like universities. I remember going for a meeting with someone really, really, really high up at a university. And there was me being like, what the hell am I doing? I'm just winging this. And I went for this conversation with this person to, again, like, how could I help? How can I support? My mission is to really help women in business. And I know, like, I started my business at university. So it's like, what can we do? What can I get involved in? I also connected with the university I went to, the University of Birmingham. And I was just like, here's what I'm doing. How can I help? And so I was like getting in touch with people with that might or might not be able to, where I could support them and help them, but maybe they would be able to open some doors for me. So I looked for organizations. So there was like organizations, there was universities, and also charities, and like looking at like who else can you get involved with? What else is going on? And so you might be like in the health and wellness space, or you might be in mental health, or it could be blooming anything. There's organizations for so many different things. And maybe you're like, Carrie, there's not an organization for the kind of the thing I'm doing. Well, one, maybe there is, but two, okay, let's get creative and think about what is going on that you could get involved with, get involved in. Because I think so often we are so, especially when we start businesses in this day and age in like the online space, we put ourselves in the online box, in this online bubble, and we don't think outside of the bubble. I'm saying pop the bloody bubble, get outside of that online bubble and look for opportunities on the ground. Look for opportunities around you where you can connect in person with people, where you can physically go and connect with other organizations on the ground. Like, I just really think that when we do this, we can have much bigger impact and build so much more momentum. So for me, that's what I was doing. I was building these relationships. And then I was looking for other opportunities. Now, I will say, I did use LinkedIn in those days. And I remember learning about LinkedIn from a networking event I was going to. There was somebody who ran the networking events. And she was like, Carrie, you need to get on LinkedIn. You need to start connecting with people on LinkedIn. I was like, okay, I will do it. And so I got on LinkedIn and I started to join relevant groups. And I started to connect with people. And again, like, It was a meaningful connection. I think if you are going to be on social media, then it has to be meaningful connections. Like, there's so much, you can do so much with 10 followers. Like, you can be on their profiles and looking at like, what are they posting out? And then when they post something out, you could be like, oh my gosh, like, I just wanted to send you a message because I really resonated with that what you shared. Absolutely love it. And just send a genuine, heartfelt message to somebody that's real, that's authentic, that's true. And it will be incredible, the conversations that will flow when somebody genuinely feels seen and heard and validated from you. And so on LinkedIn, that's what I was doing. I was genuinely interested in these people. I was going to check out their profiles. What was going on for them? What were they doing? What were they achieving? And then validating them and what they'd accomplished, and then building relationships with people. And then what I found is people would reach out to me for opportunities, and I was like, literally became a yes person. And I think there's a time and a place for becoming a yes person. I don't think it's something we can be all the time, because that would be a bit crazy. But for me back then, I really wanted to build this momentum. So I did become a yes person, and I was like, yes, I will go along to that. Yes, I will go along to that. And so there were events I was invited to go down to in London, and I was like, oh my gosh, what am I even doing? And I would literally be on the train from between Manchester and London all the time, like every week, backwards and forwards, just traveling around, connecting with people. And in doing that, I got to meet some other amazing people, and my network started to expand in London. And before I knew it, I was connected with these amazing people. One of them nominated me for an award that was amazing. I then got an invite to Buckingham Palace. I got to go and have lunch at the House of Lords. I'd built this advisory board around me with these people who were absolutely amazing. They had built incredible businesses. They'd made millions and millions and millions. And there I was at the House of Lords having lunch with them, where they were giving me advice. And I was like, how have I got myself in this situation? Like, this is phenomenal. And it is literally just from showing up and starting really small, starting literally on my doorstep with connecting and casting the vision, the mission. Like, I wasn't, like I said, I wasn't selling anything. I wasn't selling a single thing. I was just kind of trying to build up this visionist platform for myself. And in doing that, there were opportunities that arose that I could never have foreseen. There were ideas that came to me because people helped me to see the ideas. There were just so many amazing relationships and connections that just helped me to feel like, Blumenet, I'm on the right tracks with this. Momentum is building and I'm really getting somewhere. And every single one of us can do this when we put ourselves out there and we cast the vision of what we're trying to create, of what we're doing, and we bring people on board with our mission with us. And if you even start to do that locally and be like, how can I get known locally for what I want to do? And I mean, even if you go on Google and you look at like what the population of your local area is, like I live somewhere called Wilmslow and the local population is like 25,000, that's so many people. Like there's literally, you know, hundreds if not thousands of women in business that live right on my doorstep. And so back then, that's what I was doing. I was really getting in to these circles, these connections and making amazing, I mean, I made so many amazing friends and it was just so nice. And then if you think about your local city, I mean, I think I just don't even know actually what Manchester is, but so many people. So, and you might be like, well, Carrie, I live in the middle of Blumen nowhere. But then maybe you could travel to your local city and find what amazing events are going on in your local city. Or take this mindset and this concept and apply it online, like I said before. So instead of being like, I want to get 1,000 followers, forget the followers. It's so meaningless. It's so pointless. And instead think about how can I build one amazing relationship, then two, then three, then four, then 10, then 20. Like how can I build amazing relationships? How can I show up and like actually communicate with these people and show them that I care, show them that I'm here to build really, you know, really meaningful relationships? What groups could I be part of and how am I showing up in those groups? For example, inside of our membership and inside of Create and Sell, we have basically business mentors, Ken's, Katie, Stephanie, and Beauty. And they are absolutely amazing. The only reason we know that like me and the team knew they existed is because they showed up and networked and connected and built relationships with us, with the team. Like they showed up. And because they showed up, we all saw how blooming amazing they are. And then we were like, well, blimey, let's work with you. Let's do more with you. And it's the same now. Like, for example, in the membership, we just launched our cheerleaders. And those cheerleaders are the people that are showing up, that we're seeing showing up, that are there. And we're like, oh my gosh, like you are showing up and really contributing positively. So you can still apply the same concept. It's like, instead of this whole social media grind of, bloody hell, I need so much content to post out when I'm pumping out content, and I can't even keep up and it feels so overwhelming. I don't even know what to blooming put out there. And I feel like I'm a blooming performing monkey. Instead of all of that and looking at like, I want followers and I want that, all that stuff. Like I just feel like that is a recipe for us feeling like crap about ourselves. It makes us feel like we don't have enough hours in the day to do all the things we need to do. We get so sucked in to social media. And then we're like, well, this didn't even bloody make a single bit of difference anyway. So what the hell was the point? And so instead of that, it's just looking at it from like, how can I build meaningful relationships? And like, how can I get known for what I want to be known for? And that is not selling what you're selling. It's casting the vision of the mission that you have. So I would say, if you don't really clearly know what your mission is, figure it out. You've got to have a compelling mission that other people are going to want to stand with you on. Like, what is your mission? What is your movement that you are building for yourself? Like, have a movement. It doesn't matter what it is you're selling. Like, now I have a membership and I have courses, but what connects all of the things I do is my mission, my big mission, that I am here to help women to actually build successful businesses and to feel really inspired and empowered, like they can actually do it. And obviously, like, I mean, it is pretty generic. But you know what? That's what I blooming want to do. that is what I want to do. But when I infuse my story into that and why I'm doing it and my experiences of being that entrepreneur that would felt so lonely and isolated, I would go along to networking events and I would be like this. I mean, at the time I was like in my 20s and I would be surrounded by men in suits. And like I had experiences where I would go and talk to a guy and they would literally like just not even make eye contact with me and just be so dismissive of me as if like, I haven't got time to speak to you. Like, who the hell are you? And it happened so many times and it was so frustrating. So when I share these experiences with people, they can get on board with me. Any man or woman who disagrees with what that person did to me gets on board with my vision. And it's like, bloody hell, that's really awful that that happened. Because it's just a human connection point. So what are your human connection points when you're casting your vision? What are your human connection points that are going to really get people to buy into that vision? So like I said, for me, that's what I was doing at the beginning. And I didn't know how it was all going to work out. And like, at the beginning when you're like, okay, I've found one event to go to, and then you go to that event and that event's pretty crap. It's like, okay, yeah, you could get disheartened at that point, but you just have to keep going and keep going and keep connecting. And when you find one person that's really great, and then what other events do they go to? Or how else, you know, what other opportunities are there? And just, it's just literally, I think as you turn this part of you on, like you get in this zone of like gonna go for it and do that and get known locally, I think once you'd start to do that, you'll be surprised at the opportunities that flow, the ideas that just start popping up around you. It's like, you know, that whole thing of like you really like a certain type of car and then all of a sudden you start seeing that car everywhere. It's like once you get your committed to, I'm gonna get known locally and I'm gonna find local events to go to, you will just start seeing them popping up. And so literally opening your mind up to doing this and then like keeping a lookout and then jumping on the opportunities. The other thing I was also going to say is like getting involved in, there's a few more pieces I wanted to say. One, get involved in local media. They're always looking for stories. So in the early days of FEA, I think it was in 2011, I was getting involved in opportunities to be on local radio shows. So I was on one local radio show through a networking event that I'd started going to where they were connected with this little radio station. So I went on there, and even though it was a really small radio station, it felt like I was building momentum all of a sudden. When like, for example, my mum and dad were asking like, what are you doing? I'd be like, I'm going on the radio today. And they're like, why are you going on the radio today? And I'd be like, yeah. And so it was just, it felt like I was doing something and I was like pretty cool. And then I remember going down to a local like fair that was on at the park, and the local radio station were there. And so I went over and started talking to them, and I was like, I'm on this mission to help women to build successful businesses. This is what I'm doing. Like, would I be able to come on and like talk about it and how I could help? And so I ended up going on a bigger local radio. And I remember it was like, I was really nervous, and it was like a proper like studio. And like, I mean, this was like a much bigger radio show. And I did this interview with them and it was just amazing. And I will never forget because like my sister and brother were listening in, and like they filmed the audio of it. And I don't even know how this came out of my mouth, but I was talking and I was saying the word fear, but instead of saying fear, I said fur. I don't even know how that, I mean, I think James to this day still has the audio clip. And they literally replayed that clip of me saying that over and over and over again. It was funny. But it was an amazing experience. And again, it felt like momentum was building. Like, oh my gosh, I'm on this bigger radio show. And I got in touch with local media. So this was my other second point. My other point was, if there aren't any good local events going on, blooming create one. So I, a few months into starting FEA, so I started FEA really in the February 2011. I think it was May, I hosted an event. So it was only a few months in, and I'd connected a network that much that when I hosted this event, I think it's like 50 quid or something. And I had like 50 or 60 women come to this event that I hosted. And then some of them had stalls and like paid more to have a stall where they could have, like they could showcase their products and stuff. And we had canapes and there was a drinks voucher, and we did like a little tote bag and we put some goodies in there. And I was like, oh my gosh, like, a few months ago, I wasn't doing any of this. And then now I'm hosting this event for 60 women and it was amazing. And I'd also called up the Manchester Evening News, which is a newspaper, and told them about what I was doing. And I remember a photographer came along from the Manchester Evening News and it was just, it was an incredible moment. It was like, again, it was like, oh my gosh, a few months ago, it was just me sat there feeling really crappy about myself because I was stuck in my own way. And now look at me, I'm hosting this event. The Manchester Evening News have come. They're taking pictures of me at this event. I was just like, I felt on fire. I felt like momentum was really building. And all of these little things just helped to build the big picture of like where I was going. So it was incredible. So again, what local opportunities are there? And I remember doing things like, there was like, but there's a local like celebrity person, Colleen Rooney, who's Wayne Rooney's wife. And, she was often involved in like different stuff that went on locally. And so my dad had told me where they lived. So I literally wrote this little invite for her and like went, found her house and posted it through the letterbox. And like, I did things like that. Obviously she didn't come and I never heard back from her, but like, I would do little things like that and like try and like reach out, like see what's possible. And I think in, as a connection point to like reaching out to people like Colleen Rooney, I also started to recognize that when I was associated, for example, when I hosted my own event, people looked at me differently, because when you go along to an event and you meet the host of the event, you perceive the host of the event differently to be the way you perceive the people attending the event. You perceive the host of the event in a, you kind of have like, a, I mean, I felt this from going along to events, like whoever ran the event, I just had held them in a higher position of kind of authority, really. And I was kind of really impressed by what they'd created. They were the leader. They were leading the group of us. And so that's the way I viewed them. And so with also, so it was kind of like, how can I put myself into a position where that, you know, I'm kind of doing that more and I'm leading this vision, but then also reaching out to other people that can help elevate my level of visibility, my authority, my presence, my profile. And so when I, back in 2012, when I started my digital magazine, I obviously began reaching out to like really big names and, you know, Kim Kiyosaki, who'd written Rich Woman again, which I had loved. And I was like, okay, I really want to interview you. And so I literally reached out and the magazine didn't even exist. And my audience was pretty small. And she said yes to being interviewed. I was like, oh, wow. And being able to interview people like her and, you know, other people on the cover, like Gabrielle Bernstein and, you know, some incredible entrepreneurs. And again, it helped me to be seen alongside me and FEA to be seen alongside those big names. And again, it helped raise my profile. And so like, who could you be reaching out to? Who could you connect with? So often we're just like, God, that person would never say yes. Or we just feel like it's unrealistic for us to reach out. But like, we don't blooming know unless we try. And some people are going to knock you back 100%. But like, there might be one person that actually says yes. And so just get involved. Like I remember as well, like Stella and Dot, that massive company, they had a branch in London, and I somehow managed to get involved with Stella and Dot because I was like, hang on, there's loads of these people selling Stella and Dot as a Stella and Dot stylists. I could be useful. I could help with FEA stuff and like what I'm teaching. And so again, I made connections and then managed to interview Jessica, the founder of Stella and Dot. And like there I was at this big rally event that they had in London where she was speaking. And then I was there and got taken afterwards to go and interview her. And I was like, oh my gosh, like I'm doing some really cool things. But it was just showing up and connecting and putting myself out there. And again, casting the vision of what I was trying to create. So we can all do this when we have a clear mission and a vision to get behind. And again, you don't need to be selling anything. This is not about selling anything. It's about building your platform. It's about building these relationships, opening the doors, opening opportunities. It's building momentum. And from that place, you will create so much success for yourself. And it's so exciting. And if I were starting a business from scratch all over again tomorrow, I would do that exact same thing. I would get myself out there locally. What are the organizations I could connect with? What are the events I could go to? What are the people I could get to know? And I remember talking to Katie, one of our business mentors, about this. And she said in 2018, when she started her new business, it was actually a social media business, but she started it by networking locally in Bristol and connecting with people. And then she was like, there wasn't the kind of networking events on that I wanted to see. And so I created my own networking event. And so she created her own thing and got people together. So again, like, it's so powerful. And that's how she said she got a business off the ground, from doing that, from networking, connecting, and word of mouth locally. So there's so much power in it. I just want you to share this, open up your mind. I mean, because obviously I'm not sharing anything new. This stuff's been around for blooming ages. But I think we just kind of maybe lost touch with it as we become so much more connected to this online world with social media, and feel pressure that we need to be building an online presence and that we need to be building a following. And I just feel like it's just nonsense. Like, don't get me wrong, social media can be really effective and really powerful, but it can also bloomin' be quite slow, and it can also be a waste of bloomin' time. You don't need social media to build a successful business. And if anything, I would say start offline. Start offline first and build those relationships and connections. And if you are going to do online, then look at it from the lens of how can I build powerful relationships and really, really great relationships where I can help people and I can get people on board with my mission. And I think it will be such a game changer. So I really hope you feel liberated by this if you have been feeling bogged down with the pressure of social media and keeping up and feeling like it's not blooming getting me a result anyway. I hope that it's like, oh my gosh, yes, you've just made me realize that like there's so much potential around me. I mean, go on Google, go and look at how many people live in your local area or your nearest city, and then just be like, right, I'm going to get known for what I want to do. I'm going to get known for what I do. I want people to know me and what I'm about, and get out there and start connecting and serving and being helpful and building those relationships. And I just think you won't even be able to foresee all the amazing opportunities and things that are going to come your way. I think it's going to blow you away. And it can happen faster than you think. I mean, look at me, from going from nothing to then hosting my own event within a few months. I mean, it can be that fast that you can build momentum that fast. And then just to put into perspective on a timeline, I started FEA in the February 2011. By the September 2012, I was nominated for that big award and I won that award. And I then got my advisory board around me of those amazing people. And then it was the January 2013, I think, where I got invited to Buckingham Palace. So yeah, and then... Is it 2013 or 2014? I got invited to do my TEDx talk. I can't remember, but stuff started to happen. I started to get asked to speak more. And so I just started showing up, helping out for free, just speaking for free to build my confidence, to build my experience, to get myself out there. And I will add, it's bloody scary. Like I said, I am on the introverted side. And I always want to say no to speaking events because it terrifies me. I've got a speaking event coming up in a few weeks, and Nick, who runs the event, has asked me 3 times to speak. The first time I said yes and I did it. The second time I said no. And this third time he said, ask me, and every part of me wanted to say no. And then the word yes came out of my mouth. Because it's terrifying. It terrifies me. But it's like, how badly do you want to build your business? How badly do you want to create success? How badly do you want to have an impact and make a difference in this world? And if you do, then you have to show up for it. And it's going to be scary, but if you want it, then you've got to show up for it and push yourself outside of your comfort zone. And it's liberating and thrilling at the same time as being terrifying. Because it still terrifies me to this day. But anyway, I just want to share that with you. I hope that I've given you some things to think about, and I just really hope that I can help you to really build a successful business and to realize that you can build so much momentum. And it doesn't have to be complicated. It really doesn't. It doesn't at all. And you don't have to get so caught up in this social media bumming treadmill, hamster wheel. Oh my God, performing monkey. I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, it has its place. It does. And I do think there's a lot of value in it, but it's not the be-all, end-all, and I don't necessarily think it's the starting point either. So anyway, that is all I have to say for now. But yes, hope you found it helpful. Definitely let me know. Come and let me know on Instagram, at Female Entrepreneur Association, or at I Am Carrie Green. on social media, of course, to, yeah, let me know what you think about it. And yeah, or send an email back or leave a comment. I would absolutely love it. And also, if you do enjoy listening to this podcast and you could spare a moment to leave me a review on Apple Podcasts, that would be so amazing, because the more reviews I get, the more visibility the podcast gets, the more people discover it and listen to it. So that would be amazing. Anyway, I hope you have a wonderful week, and I will be back next Tuesday with another episode of the She Means Business Show. So hopefully I will see you then. All right, take care. Bye. I hope you've loved this week's episode of the She Means Business Show. If you want more help and support to build a wildly successful business, then join hundreds of thousands of women and become an FEA insider. You'll get access to some of our amazing freebies, to our bonuses, to our giveaways, to so much good stuff. You can join me over at fea.link/insider to get all of the goodness. And I will see you next week for another episode of the She Means Business Show.